The broadcast is now starting. All attendees are in listen-only mode.
Yeah, I would like to welcome you to the RadarScreen TradeStation Global webinar. My name is Christian Walter. I'm using TradeStation, the old version TradeStation Securities, since 2004. And to be honest, the first time I saw TradeStation, the most powerful tool for me was RadarScreen, and most impressive thing what I saw before in my trading experience was this time RadarScreen. And till the moment, 15 years later, it's still one of the powerful tools here in TradeStation, also in the TradeStation Global platform. And I would like to give you some ideas how you can use this for your trading, especially if you have different symbols. Then this might help you in your selections, and you can filter different things. But this we will all see later in our presentation, and then we will also enter live to the TradeStation itself. Maybe a few things about me. I'm using TradeStation, like I said, since 2004. Started as a private trader. Later, I was able to do the TradeStation support in Germany or in German-speaking countries like Switzerland and Austria. As you can hear, I'm not a native speaker, so hopefully you will be able to understand most of the things I would like to explain. And feel free to also ask questions during the webinar. You have a chat function in your GoToWebinar menu where you will be able to chat with me, and if there's anything you don't understand or I need to repeat or anything else what is important for your for yourself, just feel free to ask me. Feel free to ask me what is important for the use of your RadarScreen. Yeah, for the beginning, this is the disclaimer, just to inform you that we are not able to provide any informations regarding trading advices, the normal thing what we should present in the beginning. And I would like to do it quite quick for the next pages so that we have more time to go deeply in RadarScreen TradeStation itself. As you might already know, as a TradeStation user, TradeStation Global user, this is something new that TradeStation and the Active Broker are coming together. It's pretty impressive that we have now access to all global markets and TradeStation as an award-winning platform. I think this was something what I hoped in the past, that there will be the availability to trade more markets than it was before, only with the US markets, for example. Yeah, direct access to world's major markets and exchanges, and you can see you can trade, of course, stocks, forex, futures, and many more. As I already said, this is normally nothing new for you. Some facts about TradeStation itself: we have 180 technical indicators included, 120 global markets, which are coming from the Interactive Broker side, 22 currencies, and most important, you can customize all your trading setups. And this is something what I want to show you today and what I would like to present you during the webinar. You will also find later the recording of the whole webinar, and we would send you the link for our YouTube playlist, especially for our English webinars regarding TradeStation Global. Yeah, powerful control for your trading. These are three tools: Radar Screen, Matrix, and Easy Language. Especially Matrix will be also part of the next webinars. As you might already know, in the TradeStation calendar, you will find the next dates, upcoming dates for the next webinars itself. And easy language, we need to decide if it's important, if you want to learn something about programming, some easy steps for the beginning. Of course, we can also provide a webinar related to the easy language itself. And as I already told you in the beginning, for us it's really important to get a feedback from you if there's anything where you are struggling or where you have problems in your daily use of the TradeStation platform. Please let us know. I mean, we can call you, give direct private lessons as well, but we want to include, of course, this content also in a webinar for everyone. And normally, if there's a problem where which you can't solve, maybe some other users are having the same. So it's always important to get a feedback and to have a direct conversation if there's any support needed from our side. So the first thing, that's where I want to start with the TradeStation platform itself. How to sort and link different symbols. This is, I think, for the beginning, very important that you know how to do this and how to use the symbol link. As you can see in the screen now, this is a sample. An example for one radar screen where I just included like randomly some index ETFs, commodity ETFs, and equities and some currencies. And if you want to link this, you always can see on the right top there's the letter S, and if you click on the drawdown menu, you can see different symbol links. It's really important if you use more than one monitor or different workspaces that you use this global symbol link. For example, I put on green global symbol link means when I go, for example, to Amazon and I click in my second workspace where I have the chart window, what was our topic last week and the last seminar, you can see chart window for Amazon, 5 minutes interval is already there. Matrix should come up as well. And if I go to eBay, for example, same concept. Normally it will show the, well, let's go to Facebook, the radar screen and chart for these different symbols. Later, I will also show you how to include these symbols in the radar screen or how to customize maybe own equity lists, own trading lists, what is yeah easier for the next time if you use a radar screen to include this. With a few clicks, but this will be presented later in the webinar. So linking, you can do two types of linking: a simple link, like I said, global and local. Local is I can show you another example only for the workspace itself. So if I want to do it just inside one workspace, then global is the thing what I normally use. And if I have more than one workspace or using different monitors, then you should always go for the global linking. So it's the one you use outside the different workspaces. So you can see it's local. So for example, if I go to Netflix here, it will just show Netflix in my workspace itself. And if I go to the other one, it's still Facebook showing on the chart window on the right-hand side. This we can close. If there's any workspace which you would like to have at the end, we are able to send workspaces. Even I have some small tools, indicators, which are not general added to the TradeStation 9.5. So feel free to contact us. We are able to provide this information or this workspaces to you. So you can also use it at home. So everything what will be presented in our webinars is free of charge, of course, and you can use this also for your own trading setups, just to inform you regarding these information. And the second thing what you can also link, what is my opinion not so important, is the interval. Means I have here 5 minutes. So if I change any settings related to the interval, it will be also shown in the chart. But normally, especially for the chart, I open not only one chart for 5 minutes. I will open a second one on daily basis or weekly basis. So the linking for the interval itself, for me, it's not really necessary, but it's able, or you are able to do this, makes only sense with chart and radar screen, because in other tools which you can of course also link, like Matrix or time and sales hotlist, there is no interval setting. So this is the two types of linking, interval and symbol. I think if you are a user of TWS, it's pretty much the same. You can also link groups there and different tools. So I think this should be nothing new, or you can use this also in all different platform, mostly in the same way. For me, important is the sorting tool, where you can sort symbols. You can do this easily with a double click. For example, if I want to see, I have here volume and rate of change. If I want to see which stock, for example, has the biggest volume change, just to remember, we are talking about a volume change in a 5 minute bar. So it means if there's like during the 5 minutes now a big increase of volume change, you will see this here in this column. If there's a minus, of course, then it's lower than the average of the last 14 bars. And to sort this, just a double click on it. So you can see eBay, for example, has the biggest, or had the biggest volume change in the last 5 minutes, comparing to the average what we had before. Pretty simple. I think in an Excel file you can do this in the same way, but there's also another way what is like really important if you want to have an ongoing sortation, where you just see like the top symbols always number one or number two. For this, it's also necessary to, if you have, for example, 20 or 30 different stocks, then there's no label row. Label row means everything what is written here on the on the blue row. This means like US equities, it will only sort everything between these label rows. If I delete this, the sortation will go to all the symbols which are included in the radar screen. So label rows are just important if you don't want to have any sortation between, or mix this sortation between these different symbols. Otherwise, you can do this without these label rows. So you will find eBay, for example, on top, number one or number two, with the biggest increase in the volume and rate of change. And if you want to do this like every 30 seconds to see what's going on, to just have a look on top of your radar screen, there's one function. You will find it in the menu format and then sort. And if you click on it, you have four different types, not types, but four different rows where you can add different ways of sortation. Here it's necessary with the standard indicators, for example, what we can see here in the volume rate of change, what is already added in the first. If I say keep data sorted, it doesn't make sense to add any another sortation or another sort column because you will not find anything what is like exactly the same, because the second step makes only sense if there's in the first step the same number. So what we normally do if we change indicators for our own use, I will do a like a binary sortation. If there's like a rate of change more than 100%, it will get one or below zero. So then you can go to the second or third row to add another sortation. If there's something what you want to do, let us know. These are really easy steps what we can change in easy language where we can help you and support these things. So yeah, just feel free. Even sometimes it's like a little bit more complicated, you can still ask us and we will tell you if we can do it in a few minutes and provide you the indicators with the sortation function, which you might or which you want to use. So easy format, sort, and then you can see every different column in radar screen I can use. Also RSI, if I want to see if something is overbought or oversold, this is also something what I can add here in the sort function. And many more. I mean, we have 180 technical indicators. Not all of them are able to use in the radar screen, but mostly or mainly the basic tools you can also use in a radar screen, and of course you can also use this for the automatic sorting function, what you can keep updated every 30 seconds, every 1 2 minutes. You can of course change the settings easily here in this window. So these two facts are really important for working with let's say more than 5 or 10 symbols in radar screen. I would say linking this window with the chart makes also sense if you just use five, but in automatic sorting function is important if there's like some more symbols like we have it here in our example what you can see on your screen. So this is the first very important fact what we would like to show you. And secondly, is how to insert symbols. There are also different ways how you can insert symbols in radar screen itself, and I would like to show you some easy ways how to do this. Of course, as we can see here, I can just add with a right click a label row and add some maybe future symbols, some other stocks, some other currency, whatever I want to insert. It's just easy if you know the symbol itself. So you can, for example, AMD, just use the symbol and then you can choose between the different markets. For example, AMD is also listed in Switzerland or in Germany. So just make sure that you choose in the symbol in the right currency. Normally, I go for AMD and then USD, Nasdaq Smart. Then you have the the symbol with the biggest liquidity from the US market. But if you want to trade AMD in Switzerland or Europe, you can also choose it from this drop down menu. And this is really important to have a look to select the right symbol here, for example. This is one way to add a symbol. If you know it already, it's pretty easy. The other way is you can also use right click and then insert symbol. There you have like a lookup function where you can search for different symbols if you're not sure you want to trade, I don't know, one company where you only know the name. You can use this way to find out which symbol you have to add to see this in your radar screen. And what I said in the beginning is also helpful for the future. You can create your own symbol list. We will also provide you some symbol lists in the future, so it makes it easier for you to add this to your radar screen. I just select my symbols, then right click on it, and here I can say append selected symbols to custom symbol list. So I can create my own list, custom symbol list. I will name it just with the date, webinar 0508, and then I can click OK. And every time I want to add one symbol more, for example AMD, I can also say append AMD to selected symbol list. And this is also pretty easy. Custom symbol list webinar, and I will just add AMD as well. And if I open now a new radar screen, I can just use this whole list, right click, insert symbol list, and you can see here is my webinar symbol list with all the symbols I just added. So it makes it easier for the future to use your own symbol list with your favorite stocks, with your favorite futures, whatever you want to use. You can of course create also different symbol lists, so this is easier to include a whole list in a new radar screen. That's the way how to insert symbols or whole lists. And if you want to add something here between the label rows, just do the following. You can right click on the row number and then insert a blank row, and with insert blank row you are able to just you have a free space where you can enter any new US equity, for example, or any new Forex if it's necessary to add something, and delete. Yeah, it's pretty easy. Just click on the symbol and then click on delete or right click on it. Right click is also the easiest step to access most of the things which you can change or use in radar screen or in chart analysis or in other tools as well. Same way, for example, if I want to change the interval, I just right click on the symbol, format all symbols, and then all the calculation, let's say RSI or volume rate of change, is based on the selected interval. And if I go on daily, every calculation will be done on a daily basis. So this is also important to change the interval. Just right click on it and then format all symbols, and you're also able to include symbols in different intervals. What is also pretty simple, I can show you this, for example. So format selected symbols, I go on 5-minute base, copy paste, and now I have the same symbols below on a daily base. So Radar Screen is also able to provide information on different bases, daily, weekly, minute chart or minute bar. You just need to add the interval itself a second time, and then you're able to change this. So for some indicators, it might be necessary to have it in different bar timings, like 5, 10, 15 minutes. So this is also possible to show in Radar Screen itself. So this was how to insert symbols and how to change the interval itself. Let's go to the next topic in our presentation. Is how to place orders in Radar Screen. It's also possible to just place an order direct from Radar Screen. There's one way with the hotkey, but I can also show you a different way, what might be a little bit not easier, but more helpful, because normally in Radar Screen you can see a lot of information, but to decide if you want to buy or sell it, I think most of you need to see some chart information or some news, some more data. So it's, I think, better to use this simple link and then place the order from matrix or from chart analysis itself. But to show you, there's a way to do it also direct inside Radar Screen. For example, we can use it, let's say, on AT&T. You see, I just have AT&T, and then if I click, just a second. You go to format hotkeys, and then you have order entry macros. You can see by market, for example, is F9. So if I click F9 on the keyboard, it will just buy automatically here outside the Radar Screen. It's 500 shares, so the normal hotkeys are having a pretty high position size. If you really want to use it, I would suggest that you change these settings and use different sizes or like dollar based sizes. But with the hotkeys and the order entry macros, you're also able to do this direct outside Radar Screen without accessing any chart analysis or the matrix itself. And the way how I normally do it is, let's say you'll stay with AT&T, I go to chart analysis. We can see here 5 minutes chart of AT&T, and there you have the possibility to use the chart trading. And here I can just change position size, and I can place a trailing stop, buy, sell trailing stop, market order, all the things what we discussed the last week in our last webinar, what you can also see on our YouTube channel. So I think this or the other way with the tool matrix should be easier way to have more information before you enter the market with any new order. So these are the topics what we had in our presentation. I mean, what you normally also can see on the TradeStation calendar. Now I want to go a little bit deeper in the indicators, in the columns you can see, how you can change the settings for all the columns here. Just easy if you don't want to see the interval because you always use it on daily basis, just right click on it and delete it. This we will explain later. This is some of our own programs which we normally use. Description makes it sometimes if there are symbols you don't know which company is behind it, will just show you the or gives you the explanation that the T symbol stands for the company AT&T Incorporation or Google for Alphabet. Something like this, if you don't need it, can also delete it. And if you want to add something, same way what I said a couple of minutes ago, just use right click, format all, analysis techniques, and then you will have this window where you can see on the right-hand side all the indicators or columns which I already included. And left, these are the 180 or almost these 180 indicators which we seen on our PowerPoint presentation. And you can just add the information what you want to see in the screen itself. You can also see like moving average, just numbers. I don't think this is really important, but volume, what we already have, volume rate of change or volatility. And here it's also the same like we seen this last week in the chart analysis. If you don't know, for example, what volatility will show you or give you for as a result, you can just click on definition and it will just give you explanation from the TradeStation web help with the information what do you normally see as in a chart window, which are the inputs you can change, because this is the next thing what I would like to show you. We can There's anything what you want to see, I can include. Let's say we will add the 52 or the yearly high and low. So we will see this information also in our radar screen. And if you want to change anything for any indicator, just right click on it and format. And then you are accessing here the inputs where you can change, for example, the length where it's calculated for RSI or like oversold, overbought, what is later necessary or important for alert function, what's the next step, what I want to show you. Even color you can change for the numbers itself, but I think the most important things are these two things, input and alerts. These are the two things which I normally use for my settings, and the alert function what we already showed you last week for the chart window. The chart window itself can be used in the same way like for the radar screen. And especially if you have like 20, 25 different symbols and you want to just see if it's overbought or oversold, which means if the value goes below the 30 or above the 70, in this indicator RSI, you will get a notification, and this notification you can just change the setting for sound, for pop-up window. And as I explained it last week, I think this makes your trading much more efficient. Because if you think back, you are having 20 symbols, 20 stocks you want to trade, you will need to check all the different charts, and you need maybe to put some horizontal lines. Here it's important that you can use the same settings for all these symbols here, and it will give us sound notification, means What you can see here, just a second, I need to change it. To alert once, you can change it alert once or alert once per bar. If you do it continuously, you can see, like, especially in in the movements of today and yesterday, where the market's going down a lot, you will find, of course, all stocks are giving alerts or signals. So it's just important to use the right signals, the right notifications, so you don't get overloaded by all these alerts. But what I want to say, if there's any alert and I'm using, for example, another workspace, or I'm opening any website and there's this pop-up window, I just need to click on the pop-up window and it will just jump direct in the workspace I'm using, for example, radar screen, or when I use it in the chart analysis window, it will go direct to the workspace where this alert came from. These are the two important settings for alerts and inputs. And if we go back to our overview, we can also change, of course, the columns itself, because I don't want to need to see what's the number of overbought and oversold, because it's always the same, the 30 and 70, which I can change in the inputs. So same for volume and rate of change, I can hide plots which are not necessary to see in here, like the zero line. It's important in a chart window, but not important here in a radar screen itself. So just right click on it on the top, and then you will see show hide plots, where you can easily just change this. And it's also possible, for example, if you just want to get the alert, you can make it like small, or you can hide all the columns and the alert will still come up if there's anything happening, like we have it here, for example, Cisco and Amazon. They are overbought on a daily basis, so let's go on back on 5 minutes, so I can. So let's see Euro SGD. I click on it and direct. It jumps to the radar screen where I can see Singapore dollar. It's at the moment overbought. What I can see here with the red numbers, which means it's above the 70 range, and this makes it very easy and efficient if you're not in front of the computer the whole time. So you can just write an email, do other stuff, and when there's a big movement like what we had yesterday in I think all big indices in the US, let's just see it, for example, on S&P 500, then you will get a notification if there's a volume increase, which I also included in our radar screen, or if there's like something happening. And that's also some other indicator which I normally use for my own setups. You can see here the indicator on the second column, it's alert radar screen. You just right click on it. Let's make an example. We can use for this Apple to see it in a chart. It's now moving between 200 and 193. So when it will break out of this range, then I might have I might want to have a notification, so I can do it in two different ways. Like we showed it last week, we can just set in a horizontal line, and then this chart window needs to be open all the time, and then I will get a same pop-up window what I had here in radar screen. And for radar screen, it's even more easy. It's just here I put on this symbol. There we go. Apple and 200 and 193. You can see here these two numbers. Now they are the background is white, means there's nothing happens. If I change it, for example, to let's say 196, then we will be below this. The background will turn into red, and if I set an alert, I will get straight notification that yeah, you can see it here. Apple is trading under my range, and I set up this alert that it will come up continuously. So if there are special stocks which you really want to trade in a certain range, or if they are breaking out above, below a certain level, then it's very easy to do this here in radar screen, or as we did it last week in a chart window. You can do it in the same way, but I think it's a little bit easier to have it all in one list, and you can yeah, add as many different symbols with different levels where you want to have a notification, and then two clicks, for example, you get an alert, you click to Apple, you go to second page, you have a chart, you have maybe second chart, you have a matrix where you can add your order, you can add your trailing stop. That's the way how it works, and the trading will be like very fast, very efficient, without wasting a lot of time, and especially without sitting the whole time in front of the computer, what makes it maybe for you a little bit easier to not yeah, miss the big movements in the market where volume comes and symbols are breaking out. So I think for this, in this case, radar screen is very helpful to get a message regarding anything what happened, if it's on a daily basis, a 5 minute basis, or even 1 minute if you try to trade in smaller interval. This is also possible, and as I told you in the beginning, you can also use it in different intervals on the same time. Just have to add the symbol a second time, and this is also possible to make an analysis on a 5 minute and a daily basis in one screening. As we also created our symbol list, we can do the same for the analysis group what we have here. For example, if I just want to use volume rate of change, I want to use the RSI and my own indicator, which is included here with the alert function. I just right-click on it, and the same way what we did it in the symbol list, I will say save analysis group, and all columns in the way I you can see it in the background will be saved in this way with the sort function, if you have some sort function included, with the alert function. So your whole setup will be saved as an analysis group. This means next time if you open a radar screen, you just need to do two clicks and you have the whole analysis group included in radar screen. Yeah, pretty easy. If you want to use like a special setup for intraday or maybe for long term, you can just save these groups as different setups, and I will do the same for what we did in our symbol list. So next time I can Just add this to any new radar screen, and the same with the symbol list. So for example, what we created here, I can access now with two clicks with the US equities, which are included, and with all the indicators and alerts which we are created during the last 30 minutes. So this is, or this should give you some impression of the power of the radar screen and how to use it. I'm sure there are much more ways to make your trading more efficient with this tool. But the basic facts, to repeat it, is sort function linking radar screen with chart or other tools. Then you can insert like different intervals, different stocks, futures, forex, different symbols. Should be not coming from one class, like only stocks or only currencies. You can enter all different classes in one radar screen, and you can also use all technical indicators. You can also create your own technical indicators. So as I said in the beginning, feel free if you have any idea, or is there anything missing what you might have in any other platform. We should be able to create this for you or help you. We will show you how to access easy language. It's also pretty easy. If there's someone who wants to know the programming language, just right click on any indicator or technical analysis, and then you can see edit easy language for RSI, and you can see the source code from easy language, which will also help you to learn more about programming itself. So this is full customizable for your own trading, and this should just give you a short introduction, a short idea how you can use it, how you can access or link it with other tools, and if there's, like I said in the beginning, anyone who wants to have this workspace which we showed here in our presentation, we are able to send this via email, as well as the presentation or the video link from YouTube, where you will also find some other information regarding how to start with TradeStation or how to add market data. And in the next weeks, we will do the ongoing webinars with new topics. And if there's anything missing which you want to see in the future, just let us know. From my side, we still have 10 minutes for any question. So feel free to use the chat function on your right side to ask if there's anything, any information missing. Otherwise, I hope we will welcome you in the next week for our next webinar, how to start with TradeStation Global, or how to start with TWS. What's also important for the beginning, because you might use both platforms or you need to have them both open. So this will be our next topic. And yeah, the last 10 minutes will be here to answer all your questions. And of course, if you're just new with TradeStation, you can also use our phone number or our email contact to stay in touch with us, to let us know what is important for you, and which information we might provide you maybe in the next seminar itself. So these are the contact information which normally most of you already know: phone number, email, or our website. And yeah, I hope I could give you some impressions, some information how to get started with radar screen, and hope I can welcome you in the next week for the next webinar again. And yeah, feel free to contact us or let us know how you found the webinar, and which we should change for the future. Thanks.